It's time for another edition of Robberies Gone Wrong. This dickhead swipes a laptop, but a well-made power cable says, yeah, nah, in comes Cheryl, the day manager, with a huge grapple. She's been training in the octagon outside of work hours. She pins him, and Samantha slides in, almost going ass over tits. She calls a friend of a friend who knows how to disintegrate bodies. The bloke on the right asks if he can try on a necklace before buying it. The shopkeeper goes, yeah, sure, just don't run out the door with it. The bloke goes, nah. That would be lame. The perfect crime. Oh, fuck. The door's locked. Of course it is. What are you, dead from the neck up? Come on, give me back the payload. The wannabe thief tries to act like a genuine shopper again. This goose has always wondered why store display phones have that retractable cable on the back. And he found out. I always thought it was self-explanatory. I guess he wanted to test it. He goes back to acting like a genuine shopper. Dashcam footage now. I don't like making assumptions, but that WRX is driving very suspiciously. He's flooring it. He's fair dinkum looking to get away from the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, fucking 10 infinite police cars. He's flogged something. Perhaps he cut one of the retractable cables connected to a display phone. That would bring the full wrath of a police force down upon you. This hungry fella is entering Macca's via the drive-through window. I don't think he wants cash. He's been drinking at the pub. He's bloody famished. Or he met a Sheila and she's been drinking and she's famished. Yeah, it's like at the beginning of the Battleship movie when Lieutenant Alex Hopper steals a burrito. It wasn't for him. It was for the Sheila he was sinking piss with because she was famished. I'd say that's exactly what's going on here. Ah, crikey. I don't think he understands how deep fryers work. He wants a large fries, but he's gonna end up with hot, oily bags of shitty mashed up plastic and potato. He's bored. He's giving up. He's like, it's too much effort. Oh, he's fallen asleep. This Sheila is walking home, minding her own business, when two wankers on a little motorbike approach. She smells crime in the air and dunks her bag and her coat. The wannabe criminals are like, damn it, she's too smart. She goes, yeah, you better run. Out comes her neighbor, Carol. Kazza is like, good on you, love. Show those punk bitches who's boss. These crafty buggers have decided a car-based approach to robbing the Apple Store is the way to go. No picking locked doors, no dealing with retractable cables, no horde of employees in blue shirts at this time of night asking you if you'd like to see someone at the Genius Bar. No one needs help from the Genius Bar. Alright, time to cheese it. But the car's stuck. Dad's BMW is stuck. That is a well-made security door that they're trying to break through again. It must be Apple-made. Hard to break, but you have to buy a whole new one every year when one part breaks. The robbers go for another attempt. Nah, the car isn't fucking going anywhere. I hope the value of those iPads you nicked are worth more than the Beamer you're leaving in the Apple Store overnight.